Ask Reddit by Build Rome. If you won the lottery and didn't tell anyone, what subtle signs changes would people start noticing in your life? I think they'll notice when I stop complaining about work and start complaining about golf. Supervisor, why are you 2 hours late? Me, watch your mouth. OMG, this is the one comment that made me think about buying a lottery ticket. I've pictured all the cars and houses and travel, but being able to demand better treatment from my boss? Wow, that'd be amazing. I'd keep working long enough to call him out on his behavior. I love my job, but my boss is an ass who takes advantage of the fact I need my job. My house would be clean. Why clean? Just buy a new house and burn this one to the ground. A full set of teeth. Yeah, the fact that my answer was immediately dental care make me pretty fucking sad. Probably wondering where the hell I disappeared to. Pro-life tip, distance yourself from people before you win. They won't notice you gone even if you don't have money. Finally got new glasses. I see. I do see. I'll buy printer ink. Now let's not get too extravagant. People would know straight away. I'd reduce my hours in my job to part-time. I'm one of the lucky ones that love my job. Depending on the amount would depend on my hour reduction 50 mil plus, and I'd probably drop to relief teaching to keep my skills up and keep connections with the community. Less than 10 mil and I'd probably drop to 3 days a week. I would travel more often. I would travel. Suddenly I'd be in Japan. Smiling, I would start smiling. What's the minimum amount of money you'd need to start smiling? My phone number seems to not work anymore. New phone, who does? My car wouldn't be pulling dangerously to the right anymore. Better get that alignment or you'll wear your tires out way faster and that would be more expensive. That I am gone. I live in a state where you cannot collect anonymously, so before claiming the winnings I would have an exit plan and go live somewhere that nobody knows me. Though I am still working out how to let certain family members know without letting everyone I have ever known know by the end of the week. Gossip factor is pretty high in my family. You could change your name before collecting the winnings, then change it back afterwards, and amp, go do the public signing bit in an elaborate disguise. Possibly that my Hyundai became an Aston Martin. Even better, stick a Hyundai badge on your Aston Martin, lol. My field of FCKS would become mysteriously barren. Brilliant reference. They wouldn't. I would disappear. The part they'd notice is that I just suddenly stopped showing up to everything. Yo boss, 2 weeks from now. You gonna notice I ain't been here in 2 weeks. Michael Jr. Getting a house with a cat or two. I hope you win big. So big you also buy a property and start running your own cat sanctuary. Slight improvement in address, like the better end of the next suburb. Otherwise, I wouldn't do anything else to show a win. I often feel this way myself. If I won a massive Powerball jackpot, I'd vanish long enough for the heat to die down and get my affairs in order. Then I'd settle into an upper middle class life. I don't want a mansion. Luxury cars are impractical and make you a target for everything from criminals to aggressive jealousy. Overly fine clothing, likewise, are high maintenance, and tend to force you to the fringes. There really does come a point where more is just more. And I don't really want to cross that line. I value my time and what few close relationships I keep. Money can fuck all of that up in a hurry, which is a privileged set of problems to be had, for sure, but, still problems. I know a couple who are multimillionaires. We're talking full-time family office staff that invests their portfolio. Their kids are out of college now. They fly first class to Europe or Bali or Japan or South Korea or Dubai or Tahiti, spend a month there, living out of top suites in luxury hotels from one city to another, dining at Michelin-starred restaurants, getting private tours to museums, exhibits, etc. They're just a couple who mostly grew up middle class, so they dress casually and look like a retired couple. Where'd they get the loot? Buying another car. Getting a nice property in the neighborhood we love. Dressing better. Working part-time. Hiring someone to meal prep for us during the week. There was a post in the DeFi subreddit a while back on inexpensive meal prepping. The couple would go to a culinary school and ask for their info to be given to someone top of their class for a sort of paid internship. They'd hire them for hourly work on a Sunday, 4-5 hours, to meal prep lunches for them for 4 days of the week. They got healthy, delicious meals and the culinary student got a decent paying part-time job and a post-school reference. I think they said they paid $25-$30 an hour and would obviously buy all the ingredients. I thought that was freaking brilliant. We wouldn't do anything crazy or obvious that we fell into a lot of money. We'd definitely want to keep it as secret as possible. Love this idea. Not a drastic change, just freeing up time to focus on the things you actually enjoy. Retiring at 42 after a mediocre career would be a bit of a giveaway. Yeah, the whole not going to work anymore, yet still having money to do basic things like eat and pay rent would probably be the biggest giveaway. They'd probably notice my top hat and monocle. People might notice upgrades in lifestyle, better clothes, dining out more, or a new car. Yet, I'd stay modest to avoid suspicion. Small luxuries like vacations or home improvements might raise eyebrows, but I downplay them to maintain secrecy. That's what I would do. And if do dine finally or go on a luxurious holiday, I just won't post it on social media. I bought a house, in this economy. And it would be truthfully suspicious, I mean for anyone. If I won a lottery big enough that I'd never have to work again, people would immediately notice that I never got a new job, but somehow I got a brand new car. Not like Lamborghini or anything like that, but I'd love to go new car shopping and see how the new Jeep Wranglers are. You just need a cover story. Tell them you've been running a small drop shipping company on Amazon and it is starting to take off. You've decided to take a chance and make it your full-time job. Then a couple months later, buy a new car. In 5 years, everyone thinks you are some kind of genius online seller. Just keep it vague. Don't mention any company names and occasionally mention that you are looking at another new venture. Keep to your strict policy of not mixing business and friendships family. Then in your obituary mention winning the lottery.